Right, and we're here with part two of May's monthly music. Doo, doo, doo. If you remember from the last episode, we're gonna get a soundboard, but we clearly don't have it yet, so we'll just make the noises with our mouth. Let
Mean, I think I'm good enough. I'm cheap,
me
so.
hear it again. Give me the air horn blast.
Boom, 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 boom.
Yeah, we'll be. I mean, if that's not enough incentive for you watching at home to donate money to the channel right now, I don't know what will be. So
I know there's nowhere for you to donate, but apparently we're asking for that now, so.
you just send it, just send the cash straight to my email. I
Just
don't know how
email me
email
cash.
works. All right, so yeah, this is a part two. So if that's a surprise to you, then you guys clearly missed out on my whole tier list last time. So make sure you
If
go
that's a
watch.
surprise to you, you didn't read the title because it says part two in it, so.
Exactly. You'd think they'd know. But make sure you go back and watch part one where I talk about my top five songs for the month of May. And Cullen just hates on them completely, per usual. And then now he's going to
I
talk
think this is his
about.
best month. Maybe last month was your best month. You stole two of mine, so I mean, almost half your list was my song.
Goodness, boy's just a straight hater. But now it's your turn, and now it's my turn to hate on you. So I will go ahead and pull up your tier list, and then we can
And
just
we already
laugh
know
at
that there's no duplicates, so.
how goofy it is.
Goofy, yeah.
How dumb this tier list is.
All right, all right, all right. So down
Boy, I think he's
in
Matthew
the very,
McConaughey.
very, very bottom. I can't do Matthew. In the B tier, that is the bottom. No C's this time. I've had a good solid 2 months without C's. Right there with that Edward looking dude, we have Daylight by David Kushner.
Bro, if you at home don't
Next.
know what that song is, you clearly have not been on social media recently. It's all over my socials at this point.
Mine too.
It's insane.
Tell me that doesn't look like Edward though from Twilight.
It definitely looks like it was taken in Washington, so I could see that.
Yeah, it reminds me of Twilight.
For sure.
Next to that, also B tier, we have Off the Knob by Marlon Craft, like the cheesemaker.
B for better be joking. That's on your tier list. I honestly don't like that song. Gonna say it. And it's because I heard this song before. Like I don't remember. Like it was on a playlist of mine, and I liked it then. And then I listened to it too much, and then I just don't like it anymore.
Okay, well, that was gross of you to say. I guess moving on, above that, in A tier, we have Post Malone's brand new song for us. It actually came out yesterday. As I was making my list, I gave it a quick five listens and threw it up there. It was a good song. That is Morning by Post Malone. And it's not spelt the way you would think it is.
No, it's spelled like you're mourning something. It's spelled exactly like it sounds.
No, because he's in a pool during the daytime. You'd think morning is in like the morning time.
No, he's clearly mourning the loss of something. Look at that picture. He's
He's in
sad.
a pool.
He's
You can't even
sad.
see his face in that picture.
He's sad. No, he's look how he's
You don't
sitting.
know if he's
Look how
sad.
he's sitting, bro.
That's how
That's
everyone sits on a pool. Like they
every
sit
time I'm
exactly
sad.
like that.
Every time I'm sad, I go stick my jean pants legs in a pool with no shirt and just sit
You
like
don't
that.
have a pool.
I didn't say my pool. I said a pool.
There's probably no pool by you. Town got like 12 people in it. That'd be a waste of money.
Yeah, and I do it to mourn, not mourn.
Okay. No one even says mourn like
Mourn.
that. If you say that, you're 12 or 50. There's nowhere in between. Moving on. Next to that. Also A tier, we have Broken a Minute by Tory Lanez. Don't know why the picture is that, because that doesn't feel like it matches the song at all. Maybe that's the picture for the album. I don't know. I Googled Broken a Minute and pulled up the exact same image that was on Spotify, so.
Is this the song? Didn't they use one of his songs in like the trial with Megan Thee Stallion? Because doesn't he rap about
Megan Thee
sh
Stallion.
Megan Thee
I don't
Stallion?
think it was this song, because I'm pretty sure the
Okay.
song came out beforehand. I think. I don't know any of the
Beep.
any of the stuff with that. Moving on, S tier. He finally made it. He's been struggling the last few months.
That's true.
We have Sundown by Nick D.
Such a good one.
Forgot to put the other guy. I believe it's V. Willis. I think that was the feature in that one. Which is cool because I also love multiple songs by that guy, but heard them all before these last 3 months, so I couldn't put them in any of our lists. So yeah, let's get in and listen to some of these bad boys.
All right, so first up, you had Daylight by David Kushner,
which Daylight! Honestly,
we might as well just pull up an Instagram reel at this point for this song.
We could, and then we'd have the entertainment aspect of it to keep all the people's attentions.
I love the piano for this song.
It is really good.
Right, and that's Daylight by David Kushner.
That pretty much is. Pretty much the song.
Telling myself I won't go there.
Such a good voice. Yes, such a good voice.
Trying to wash away all the blood I spill. This loss is a burden that we both share. Two sinners can atone from a lone prayer. Souls tied intertwined by pride and guilt. Darkness in the distance from the way that I've been living, but I know I can't resist it. Oh, I love it and I hate it at the same time. You and I drink the poison from the same vine. Oh, I love it and I hate it at the same time. Hiding all of our sins from the daylight. From the daylight, running from the daylight. From the daylight, running from the daylight. Oh, I love it and I hate it at the same time.
So good. His voice is... It's not even like it's smooth, but it's also not even raspy. It's just like that deepness
that
to
folk,
it.
That folk, bro. That folk music
yeah,
gets me every
so
time.
It's so good. Like you said, the piano in is so good.
Yeah.
And it's funny because before I had even seen the cover photo for it, for some reason I was getting
like forest vibes.
I don't know why. And then I saw the
good
picture.
Folk
like,
music.
Yeah, that fits.
Good folk music, yeah. It's what's crazy about the song is my dad put me onto this.
Really?
My dad
he's always on Instagram Reels.
That has to be what it was because he texted me this song. And normally I don't even like check out the songs he sends me to. But I was like, this one looks interesting. I'll check it out. And or if I do, it's like months later. And so I listened to it and I was like, oh, this is gorgeous.
It was.
Yeah,
it was
I added
good.
It and then now it's all over my Instagram. That's why it didn't make my top five is because I was like, it's been oversaturated for me at this point.
I hear so much of it.
Like, now when I hear this, all I can picture is, like, some white woman's Instagram where she posts a video about, like, her boyfriend or something. Like, it's...
Yeah, and I'm never on any of those, so I rarely hear it.
Yeah, it's still fresh for you. Yeah, so, is besides, like, the voice and, like, the piano, is there anything else that you're just really, like, loving about this?
No, it's just B-tier because it's, you know, it's good. I like his voice. I like the flow, like I said, I like the sound, but it's nothing that sticks out. I couldn't tell you any of the lines, you know, besides like the chorus, and even then it's like I don't even know the full chorus.
I couldn't tell you until we pulled up the lyrics for this. Yeah, no, it's a beautiful, beautiful lyrics though, like as you read them though, like
yeah
you and I drink the poison from the same vibe or from the daylight. Yeah,
I would drink wine with you.
Well, it's vine, but yeah.
I meant poison, but I don't know. I was thinking from the same vine, said wine meant poison. It's that.
It's
yeah, I mean.
The birth of Chinas all over again. Yeah. All right. Moving to your next B tier.
B tier.
Off the Knob with Marlon Craft and You see?
I didn't even know there was anything else on the song. Spotify only
Spotify doesn't it. Yeah, Spotify doesn't credit the other person. I wonder if that's a writer on the song. But here it is.
I love that. I don't even know what is that, a guitar? Like what is
yeah,
that bass?
It's a
maybe?
Guitar. It's an electric guitar.
It just sounds so good.
4 a.m. and I'm twisted. Off the knob, creek that is, piece of this. What you don't want, bet you both front. You and that weak ass team you with. I be in my mind where it's bleaker shit. I'm down on my town on some bleaker shit. Seem these days we don't dream of shit. If it ain't some get rich scheming shit, I'ma reach the riches, I don't fiend for it. But I fiend for love, even more for lust. Always ready to bust me some cheeks and shit. But I'm super cuffed, my predicament. I'ma need a man. When I walk in the spot, I be nervous and hot, let me breathe a bit. I'ma ask your name, but no, y'all is lame. And everybody know that I hate cheese and shit. Stuck in the crib, my recent shit. Trying to find peace and shit, but I don't have a choice, cause I ain't trying to get people sick on some decent shit. While y'all outside wildin', I think you afraid just to sit inside with yourself for a while. And yo, I need to admit, I've been forced to face up to a lot of habits that I built from sadness that I need to quit. I can feel the cold outside.
Yeah, I mean, I really like his voice.
It is a good one, yeah.
I think that's mainly what carried it for me is his voice. It feels very monotone. Right there where we ended it, it does kind of like change a little bit, but nothing like drastic. That's why it's B tier for me. Like I said, flow's great, voice is great, but there's nothing that really sticks out.
Yeah,
you can hear everything he's saying, but at the same time, you're not really hearing what he's saying.
Yeah.
I mean, there are some, you know, messages in it. You know, I'ma reach the riches. I don't fiend for it, but I fiend for love, even more for lust. Like, there are messages, but there's nothing that's like super sticking out that you're just gonna be walking around quoting. And that's why it's in my B tier.
Yeah, I mean, it's a good song, and like, yeah, I enjoy it. I'm like not big into it as much. When I first found it, I was definitely like, oh yeah, this is a great song, and I'd play it a lot, and it was on my like hip hop playlist, and I really liked it. But the more you listen to it, I think it's just because it's so monotone for most of it, and like,
yeah,
the same vibe throughout, that it's just, you can only listen to that intro so many times, and then you're just kind of like, yeah, whatever. So
that's why it's nice that it's like a shorter song, because I think it's only like, that's fair. 2 minutes.
Yeah, 2-3. Yeah. B tier, I think, is a good spot for it. All right, now we're moving up into your A tier with Morning by Post Morning. Malone.
That's actually how you sing it, too.
Yeah, Morning. You just want to sing it for us, and then we'll just go off that.
Don't want to be sober.
All right, we're just going to play the lyrics.
I messed up reading.
Okay.
The sun is killing my buzz, that's why they call it morning. Thought I was strong enough, threw my bottle at the sky, said, God, that's a warning. Don't wanna sober up, try to keep it inside, but I just wanna pour it. Thought I was strong enough, got a lot of shit to say, couldn't fit it in the chorus. I just left Wally, spent a Maserati, the way I got a flex, you think I did Pilates. Ooh. I call my quote-unquote friends, do you got plans? Turns out everyone's free when the dinner is. Then they drag me to a party out in Malibu. After 30 high noons, it was pretty cool. Tried to shoot my shot, she told me that she had a shoot. Bye-bye.
Such a fun song. It's so
depressing. You drank high noons.
That is funny. After 30 high noons. Like, that's 30 a lot of her high noons. That's crazy.
That's pretty much what we drank at that wedding.
I mean, we did have 30 high noons. That was wild.
Had at least high noons. We had enough alcohol content to equal 30 high noons. I mean,
I was wearing like a button up with two like breast pockets. It was double breasted. So I had one in each pocket.
You also had the insides of your coat.
And the insides of my coat. I was carrying six at a time.
I was like, yeah, I got to go grab another one. Yeah. You're like, oh, here. And you reach inside and grab. And I was like, oh, my God.
It's because I hated going to that drink shed with everyone in there.
Well, yeah, and everyone questioned me because I was 21 at the time. Yeah, I mean, what a good time. I think that's the reason it's day tier, just because he mentions High Noons and we met the creator of High Noons.
Plug for High Noon.
Yeah, we can just go on to the next one.
it's a fun one. If this is an indicator of what his album's going to be, though, oh my gosh.
July 25th.
Plug the album.
I'm so ready for it.
We'll have to do a listening party for that one. That'll be a fun one.
Yeah, I'll try how to legally do that one. Because I don't know how to do it, you know, with a big artist. True. I mean, yeah, it's just like, it's it feels summery for some reason. And yep. Maybe just because it's called morning. I don't know, but, you know.
It's
I mean,
the wrong morning.
It's called morning. He says, the sun is killing my buzz. Like, when I think of sun, we don't get that here. So when we get sun, it's summertime.
That's fair. It is interesting to see, like, the change in, like, how introspective he's being now compared to, like, his past albums.
Yeah.
And, I mean, he's saying, like, I just left Wally's in a Maserati. The way I got to flex, you think I did Pilates. Like, he's saying, like, I have to flex on people. Like, it's just something I have where I'm insecure to the point where I've got to do this. That's what he's saying, right? And so, yeah, just the growth we're seeing with this is a huge indicator of what this album's going to be, and I'm so excited for it.
If you wanted to flex on me by, like, throwing, like, a band on me or even, like, 100, it's whatever. Like,
I feel like that would be the bigger flex, is just paying off, like, student loans for everyone.
Yeah, if he was just like, here you go, here's, you know, 100 bands, I'd be like, okay, I guess, whatever.
All right. Are you ready for Tory Lanez?
I mean, I guess we could get on with the Lanez bros.
Is it controversial to listen to him? Is he like Kanye now, where, like, you have to only mention it to, like, a few people?
I don't care. I listen to him, and it's whatever, I mean.
That's fair. Well, here's Broken a Minute by Tory Lanez.
Heck, I ain't been broke in a minute. Word to Mazi, nigga. I don't even know if you can say damn.
And when they swing that way to the right, you swing to the left, you heard?
Bobby, yeah.
Woo! Damn, I ain't been broke in a minute. Don't get it fitted. Toe off the bow in a Bentley. Fucking your hoe in a kidney. Fuck up the city. I do not dance or jiggy. Gun is sucked under this finny. I like it, I spin it. I just came right out of jeweler. Ice on my neck and my wrist and my fist, I ain't finished. I was just working at Dennis. Came back and counted some millions. I ain't no regular civilian. Red, yellow, green. Look like my neck a chameleon. Okay, spin it. Damn, I ain't been broke in a minute. I hear this bitch, he offended. I'm a Da Vinci offended. Then let me finish. I cracked that Chevy for 40. My scammer busting bottles off the OA. I cannot cuss you fucking on my bros, eh? I'm just gonna fucking treat it like a throwaway. Ooh, damn, I ain't been broke in a minute. I'm at the mall out of business. I need a swipe in a digit. Calling up Kales. He did 250 on Biddy. It ain't no biggie. Montclair kicky. Fuck that little bit made of Viddy. She wanna leak it. She wanna send it. Hey, fuck that bitch. My face wasn't in it. Damn.
So catchy. So catchy.
Really, yeah. It's so good. It flows so, so well. Like, it's just like your head's bobbing the entire time. Even if you don't catch every line, like, there are some great lines. Where you cut it off, I wanted to cut off there because that's my favorite line in the whole song. Can't even say any of the words in it. you know, she want to leak it. She want to send it. A F that B, my face wasn't in it. I love that one. Yeah, I mean, just a great song. I think Summer for this song, that's more because, like, a party song.
Yeah.
And I do, like, a lot of summer parties. Like, I don't party much, but the summertime is when I do the most. So, like, you know, outside dancing with a drink in my hand, you know, bouncing the song. That's what I think of.
Have you heard a lot of Tory Lanez music?
I actually have. It started getting put on my Spotify made playlists like a few months ago. I'd say like probably like six.
Is he a pretty good artist, or is this like an outlier for him? Because I haven't heard a lot of Tory.
I think he's good, but this is an outlier. And this is more like a rap song. And a lot of his newer stuff is more like R&B. And I'm pretty sure, like, he originally, like, came on the scene as R&B.
Really? I didn't know that.
So this is an outlier, I think. I haven't heard, you know, everything he's made. But
yeah,
this feels like an outlier. Just this is more rap and everything else is more R&B.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's good. I mean, I like his features. I like this song. I like his R&B stuff. And I think this is an A-tier song.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. I almost put it on my list, but
I'm glad that you put it on the May playlist because I heard this song years ago.
Yeah, I literally listened to it like for the first time like a week ago.
Yeah, I heard probably when this song
where it was like my face wasn't in it. Like I've heard that before, but like I had no idea what it was from until I heard this. So.
Yeah, I've been bumping the song for a while, but as the rules state, we pick our five songs from the playlist. It doesn't have to be a song you put on there. So even though I've heard it before, he put it on the playlist. I got to take it.
Bending the rules.
Use it, so. Well, it's not bending. That's using the rules to my
breaking
bend.
The rules in half. Abusing the system.
No integrity in the monthly system.
I know we made this up, but we're still breaking the rules.
Whatever. Just move on to my S tier song.
Here she is. Sundown by Nick D.
The hell is
when
this?
The sun goes down. All the memories of you start coming on up. Does it make you proud? Knowing that hurting me didn't hurt you that much. Well, did you lie right to my face or did your mind just change? That spot you chose to hit was on my blind side, babe. And I googled what to do when a heart breaks and had to slow down your heart rate. And how the hell do I get over her? When the sun goes down, all the memories of you start coming on up. Might need another round. Cause them 90 proof shots I'm shooting ain't doing that much.
Oof. Yeah, that is such a good one. And I know we didn't listen to much of it. But I mean, if we had listened to more, we just listened to the entire thing. It is such it's a good song. I feel like I've been doing a lot of songs that give me summer vibes just because we're getting into summer more. So like, you know, I'm trying to get in that mindset.
Yeah.
And also I don't know if this is like the Wyoming in me or what, but when he says all the memories of you it sounded, it gives me like a little like southern twang kind of in my ear.
Yeah, even like Wyoming's in the west, not the south.
I said Wyoming. I didn't say, you know.
You said southern south. Twang. You said southern twang, though.
It's still southern twang. It's still what you call it.
I know.
We have the biggest rodeo in the world, okay? We can call
calm
it
down.
Twang.
Can we just talk about how this man is shooting back 90 proof shots?
I mean, that's light for me. I'd be doing, you know, 150 proof at least.
Oh, gosh. I did a 150 once, and that almost about killed me. It's rubbing alcohol is what it was.
Well, yeah, that's, I don't know
that's
if that's
70%
illegal, like,
alcohol.
Well, it's 75, but.
75, yeah.
Just
favorite,
a good song.
Yeah, my favorite's when I googled what to do when a heart breaks and how to slow down your heart rate and how the hell do I get over her. Oh, that part just, the first time I heard this, I heard that part and I restarted the song. I was like, what just happened?
That's funny because that's the exact line that caught my attention. Like I was listening to it, but I wasn't like really listening to it. Then I heard those lines and I was like, oh, okay. Like that. I have to go out and do that to me.
Yeah, that one hurts to hear.
And it's funny because like the beat sounds like it sounds upbeat, and it sounds like a higher song. But then you listen to the lyrics, and you're like, "Wow, this song sucks. Like, why am I sad now?"
Do you think? And this could just be pure speculation, but he has the song "Sunroof," right? Where he's talking about being in love and like how it's like. Head out the sunroof, big summer song, you know, stuff like that, you know.
Mm-hmm, yeah,
this is sundown. Do you think this, like, there's some sort of like story between the two? And I don't think Nick D is a big storyteller in his music in general, but if Nick D is writing from his perspective, like as someone who did just get his heart broken, is it possible but it's the same girl from Sunroof? And like that's why it's sundown, is because not only is it like, you know, like the general sundown on like a relationship, but it's the sundown on their relationship. The sunroof is closed now, and now he has to drive home alone, kind of thing.
I like that. I hope that's what it is.
I mean, not for his sake, but
isn't he married with kids?
I have no idea. That's why I said I know nothing about Nick D. But I think
it could have been, you know, artists right from any point in their life. It doesn't have to be like what's going on with them right now, but I mean, just the lyric, when the sun goes down, all the memories of you start coming on up. Like, that's exactly how I feel, because, you know, with my past, we did, you know, We hung out at night. We drove around at night. It was nice and cool. We could have the windows down. The town was empty, so it's like, you know, we could just drive. We weren't stopping for lights because they weren't on at the time. Like, when the sun goes down, that's when all the memories flip back from you too. So this song really just it hits. I connect with it. Great song, S tier. I know, but so is the song, and that's what my taste is. My taste is depressing songs that most people don't want to listen to 24/7, but I do.
I knew this would be on your list. I didn't want to take it from you. If I would have chosen, I would have put it on an S tier as well. Like this,
I'm good.
And sneak peek into part three, I might be willing to argue that this is a number one song.
It is. I was going to argue that too.
We're getting ahead of ourselves. So that was your...
Now you don't even have to watch part three because you know what number one's going to be. So
shoot. Might as well just call it the Nick D show at this point. That was your tier list. How you feeling? You liking your songs?
No, but you know,
any second guesses on tier placements?
I'm gonna put Daylight as an S tier, and that's gonna take the one spot.
And as you can tell, we did just get bought out by TikTok and Instagram, and they want to really push that sound, so they're having us move it up to number one.
If we could get bought out by anyone, that would be phenomenal. So
if those watching at home, if you have any friends that buy out people. Any amount of money will do it. Not buy people. I was very clear in my wording.
Well, you said buy out people, and I still don't like the wording of that one, but whatever. I mean, if you have anyone that's trying to sponsor this Zoom meeting music review, we're down for pretty much anything.
Not the Zoom meeting music review. That's what we need to call it.
Monthly Zoom meeting music review. That's hard to get out of the mouth.
Absolutely atrocious.
That's my tier list. Go on over, watch part three. If you didn't watch part one, go back and watch part one. Go watch all of our other monthly musics and album reviews and just everything else that we have. Support us. We're really needing it, okay?
At this point, if you like support us and like and comment, we would probably definitely be willing to have you on for an episode of Monthly Music. Like,
you could be a third co-host. I mean,
we are getting no guests at this point. I mean, I've reached out to like Tyler the Creator, Eminem, Drake. I texted LeBron the other day just to see if he was free. I think he's got like the playoffs or something going on.
If he came on, I wouldn't even be in that episode. So that's wild. I'm not a sellout. I'm not gonna lie. Just that way I can be popular.
I mean, I am a sellout. I'm not a diehard LeBron fan, but if I had the choice to be on a podcast with him, I'd be like, well, I guess if it gets me big.
No, I would do a podcast, but not even just to be big, just so I could be. I'd call him out on his we're not a flopping team. I'd be like, yes, you are. I'd pull up the clip right there.
That's brutal. You'd like make him answer for like all his flopping allegations.
Yeah, I'm like that.
Nice. Well, hopefully you guys are ready for the finale because it's going to be a doozy because we have no idea what we're doing. But we'll catch you guys next time.